Jeg gav bogen til ham. Jeg gav bogen til ham. I gave the book to him, or I gave him the book. So when you're doing a transfer, transference, it's very common that we use till, like you're passing it on from one person to the other one. De gik ned til stationen. De gik ned til stationen. They walked down to the station. Now, this one is very easy because it's direction and location. So that's pretty much the same as in English. And then why we say ned, that is a little more complicated. But we do that a lot in Danish, like ned, even though it's not physically down, just because we're going somewhere. Sometimes it's up, though. All right. Din moster kom hen til mig. Din moster kom hen til mig. Your aunt came over to me, or she approached me. And moster is, by the way, mom's sister, like mors søster, moster. So hen til is like over to, approaching, near vicinity, that is. Temperaturen er steget til 24. Temperaturen er steget til 24. The temperature has risen to 24. Right? So this is like a point, like you reach a certain point that is also till. Right? Same as in English. Till 24. Fisken kom op til overfladen. Fisken kom op til overfladen. The fish came up to the surface. It's pretty logical, eh? Again, it's going somewhere. Up til overfladen. Up to the surface. Very nice. Right. Jeg gik til højre. Jeg gik til højre. I walked or I turned to the right, the right side. I could also say til venstre, right? To the left. So that's actually the same. Til højre, til venstre, because it's direction. Very nice. Kast bolden til ham. Kast bolden til ham. Throw the ball to him, or throw him the ball, right? Like you're playing football, like in the room, let's throw or catch the ball around or whatever, and then you're like, I cast bolden til ham, to him. Yeah. All right. So, here we have. Skubbede du til mig? Skubbede du til mig? Did you push me? Did you shove me? It's kind of the same to us. Like physically. Right? Not push like pressure, but like, your body and his body, kind of thing. Skubbede du til mig? Sometimes it'll be without the tail, but that's more advanced. Explaining it is more advanced. Skubbede du til mig? Jeg prikkede til ham. Jeg prikkede til ham. I tapped him. Like on the show, like, doop, doop, hello, like that, or on Facebook. It's so annoying when people do that, but it's the same, like, at prikke. Jeg prikkede til ham. Jeg sparker til bolden. Jeg sparker til bolden. I'm kicking the ball or kicking at the ball, and that's more of an English matter how you translate it, but that's often how you hear it. Til bolden, right? Hun fløj til Italien. Hun fløj til Italien. She flew to Italy. Now, this is pretty basic because, again, til, location, going somewhere. Easy. Jeg kørte til Tyskland. Jeg kørte til Tyskland. I drove to Germany. So, again, going somewhere, right? All these are very easy, as you can see. Vi sejlede til England. Vi sejlede til England. We sailed to England. Same. Han flytter snart til Danmark. han flytter snart til Danmark. He's moving to Denmark soon, or he's soon moving to Denmark. Okay? So all of these, like these last four, Italian, Tyskland, England, Denmark, like all these, it's the same point. Like, now, flytte is a little bit different. You could also use within a country, like til en anden by, to another city. But yeah, like from one point to another, we use til. So remember that. All right. So this is a little bit different. This is like non-physical. Like the sorry, the other ones were kind of like to a point, like somewhere, a location, or physical relationship. But these are more like non-physical, and if that doesn't make sense to you, then you'll see when I go through them. Nu der kun en uge til jul. Nu der kun en uge til jul. Now there's just 1 week to Christmas, right? So like 1 week until. One more week, that's what we're saying here. En uge til jul. Lad os tælle til 10. Lad os tælle til 10. Let's count to 10. Right, so that's pretty easy. That's pretty much the same as in English. Count to 10, tælle til 10. Right? Notice that it's tælle, not tal, because tal means number, but tælle means to count. Right? They're similar, but not the same. Uh-huh. All right. Det er tid til at lave mad. Det er tid til at lave mad. It's time to cook. Now, this one is so useful. Like, tid til at, it's time to. You can use that so much. Like, it's really, really useful. Nu det tid, ikke? Now it's time. But when you have the action afterwards, you gotta have tid til at. Like, det er tid til at lave mad. Til tid at gøre det. Like, see more here. Er det tid til at stoppe? Er det tid til at stoppe? Is it time to stop? Call it a quit or whatever. Yeah. Er det tid til at stoppe? Yeah. Hvem har du ringet til? Hvem har du ringet til? Who have you or who did you call? Right. So this is kind of similar to English, at least in my understanding, but it's still different. So hvem har du ringet til? And who did you call to? Kind of like that. If you just say, hvem har du ringet, it doesn't really make sense. Right? Doesn't really make sense. So, hvem har du ringet til? Right? If I called someone, I would say, jeg ringede til ham. Right? That's the past tense, ringede. Jeg ringede til ham. Hun ringer til mig. She's calling me. Right? You gotta get the til. Alright, awesome. Hvem snakker han til? Hvem snakker han til? Who is he talking to? Because, right? Again, it's communication. Something from one person to another. Hvem snakker han til? Beautiful. Hvad sagde du til ham? Hvad sagde du til ham? What did you say to him? Like, and again, this is the same point. Communication, exchanging, passing on, yada yada. You know this by now. Hvad sagde du til ham? Now, note that in these videos, I speak pretty slowly when I pronounce these sentences, just so you can get it. But in real life, it's going to be much faster. And I know that sucks, but sometimes I have to strike a balance, and this is how we do it now. I have other more advanced videos if you want to hear like natural speed Danish, but this is a little more basic. All right. So.
Lad os skrive et brev til din far. Lad os skrive et brev til din far.
Let's write a letter for your father. Now, this is interesting. I guess in English you could say to your father as well. But in Danish you can only say til. And if you said for din far, this is such a common mistake, that would be like, I'm writing it so he doesn't have to write it. And like, I'm doing it instead of him doing it. That's different. We do say for, but that's like a favor. And but this is like dedicated to him. So when it's dedicated to someone or made for someone, then we use till. And this is a big difference from English. Right? Also with like food or presents, it's like noget til dig, something for you, not noget for dig. No, we do say for dig, but that's different. So yeah, pay attention to this because it's really important. All right.
Jeg glæder mig til på lørdag.
Jeg glæder mig til på lørdag. I'm looking forward to Saturday. Or I'm looking forward to it being Saturday, whichever you want to say. Like so, jeg glæder mig til, and some of you know this one, others might not, but it's basically like, I'm looking